Right now, the Dow is down some 200 points as Wall Street and the markets around the world react to the financial crisis playing out in Greece, which has come to a new head after festering for 5 years. It has led to an emergency shutdown in banks there until at least next Monday to prevent a run on those banks. Because of that, there are long lines at ATMs which are functioning, but there is a severe limit on withdrawals. All of this also creating complications for a large number of tourists in Greece, including many Americans. NBC's Carrie Sanders joins us live now from Athens. And Carrie, it truly is one of those situations where you wonder how you would react going to an ATM machine and not being able to get any cash out.
Well, and the reality is as you said, the machines are functioning, but there's nothing in there. The machines are empty. Now, the government had promised folks here that they would replenish the cash in the machines by noon today. That time has come and well long gone. The money is not there, so there are still the lines. Folks are going to be limited on how much money they can eventually take out when and if the money makes it in there. It's going to be limited to 60 euros a day. That's about $66. For some people, that's clearly not enough money to have cash on hand to live their day-to-day life. And so as they're looking about the fact that, Greece having the euro for so long, now it looks like, or at least many people wonder, if they're going to be returning to their previous currency, the drachma.
After 5 years of dramatic and often painful cutbacks on government services and attempts to have Greek residents actually pay their taxes, the country remains deeply indebted and now cannot make an immediate loan payment of more than $1.5 billion. The long lines at ATMs depleted of cash are not just hitting Greeks. Those here on vacation are also caught up in this financial crisis. At the Acropolis, the senior class from Palos Verdes High School in California say they're mostly out of euros, and they still have a full day to spend here before flying home.
I'm completely out of euros right now, and I feel like I can't get any more. So I had to have someone pay for my breakfast and everything.
While street protests in Athens are so far calm, some folks here on vacation say, were they to have known about this, they would have gone elsewhere on vacation.
Knowing what you know now, would you come to Greece on your vacation?
I'd have to say no to that.
And so if this is a case where folks are trying to figure out, really, this is complicated, it's monetary policy, do I really understand it? Consider it this way. In the United States, we had our own crisis with housing. So think about Greece as a homeowner who got a mortgage that they really couldn't afford, and eventually they went into foreclosure. Even though they may have stayed in the house for a little bit longer, their house was foreclosed on. That's the condition that Greece is in right now. You've got the euro basically saying, we're foreclosing on you and we're getting ready to kick you out. What are you going to do to try to stave off this foreclosure for a mortgage payment that you haven't paid in some time?
All right, Carrie, thank you very much. As mentioned, the Dow is down some 200 points here. Let me bring in CNBC's Dominic Chu. Dominic, we've seen the situation in Greece turn volatile at points over this 5 years. We've seen, obviously, now these long lines here. What we're watching on the stock markets today, at the stock markets today, is this a result of this instability in Greece and with the euro?
There's no doubt that the market move today is certainly being caused by the Greek fears and whatnot. But what a lot of traders are telling us right now is that they're surprised that the market reaction hasn't been worse to the downside. You would expect that if you have this Greek fear, this idea that Greece is going to spread all over the world in terms of that contagion, the fear of the Greek debt default and maybe them possibly leaving the euro, you'd think that the markets here would be down a lot more. European markets did take a big hit. But there's a sense here that the whatever sell-off that we've seen has been rather orderly, rather at least not as panic-driven as we would have expected to see here. Now, what's interesting about the move so far is whether or not this could have a bigger effect on the U.S. market, the U.S. stock market overall. The sense right now is that it won't have as big of an effect on the U.S. market because as much exposure as we have as a country in business to Europe, it makes up U.S. They do have exposure to Europe, but it's not like it's a huge, huge amount of it. So that's the sense that a lot of traders are telling us, at least, that you won't see that big kind of a move here. What will be key, though, Tamron, in the next couple of days, the next couple of weeks, is whether or not you see any more pronounced effects around the world. A lot of experts and economists tell us they're not seeing signs of panic yet, but that could all change if we do not get any kind of a real resolution heading towards this referendum. Back over to you.
CNBC's Dominic Chu, thank you so much.